you ever try to let go.
I'm sad, I know, yeah. I'm sad, I know, yeah.
Who am I? Someone else afraid to let go. You decide if you ever go.
What's up, guys? Welcome to my channel. If you are new here, make sure to subscribe. But yeah, so today it's a bit of a serious video, and I can understand if you don't want to watch. If you do, if you don't, sorry, just click off the video. No one's forcing you to watch this, because it is quite a serious video. It's, there's nothing gory in it, but it just might be upsetting to a few people. But yeah, if you're new here, make sure to subscribe and enjoy the video.
When you leave, who am I? Someone that's afraid to let go. You decide if you're ever gonna.
So at this point, it's just the build up to the game, just before, as the players are coming out, there's a bit of music going on, just, you know, casual, everyday football stuff. But it's when you're into it later, that's the different part. So now the players are just coming out, they are just coming out the tunnel, ready to line up on the halfway line. And you know, just every football game does it, they come out, they face one of the stands and they just face them, have the photos taken. And yeah, that's just about it for what happens here. But yeah.
Jacob Brown, number 27, Alex Mullett, number 4, Kenny Dougal, number 10, Jules Moncur. Number 29, Victor
Mayojo.
Number 19,
Keith Moore. This is where it begins to get a little bit more, I wouldn't say interesting, but more eventful, as one of the fans who's been walking with one of the flag bearers, we think, has been walking off the pitch and has collapsed, and it seems like a lot of paramedics and health assistants have been walking over to them.
Well, there was security okay, that is.
So now at this point they are bringing over blankets to close off the person who is on the floor, just so no one can take any videos or photos. But they didn't cover off the side I was at, so I got a bit of footage. Not in a bad way, just where we were stood we couldn't see, so we had to zoom in on the camera and see what was going on, so I just recorded it anyway, just for anything else.
They're going back away now, so players off.
So as you just heard from my dad, they have just decided to take the players off, just because it's so serious. Taking all the players and officials and mascots and everything else off the pitch. He's ran off to get the ball as the linesman there. And all the managerial staff from both home and away sides are leaving the pitch now. And all substitutes, just so they can get towards this person who seems to have collapsed. Just so they can provide extra help without having any distractions. Now, as you can see, all police and stewards have cordoned off this incident with blankets, stopping everybody else from seeing it, as they are providing treatment inside and they don't want any privacy, anything that's too serious getting out there, so they just cordoned it off, and this obviously intrigued people more, so they started recording it.
Oh.
As you can see now, the ambulance has turned up to provide extra assistance, but before this, it took about 20 minutes for the ambulance to get there, and in that time, the tannoy announced that there will be an air ambulance coming to pick up the injured person, and that ambulance, we presume, was for family to get to the hospital, as they can't get in the air ambulance with them. At this point, I've just frozen it just so we can get this full voiceover in, and the air ambulance is just coming around. Land on the pitch like that is quite mesmerising. And it just shows that no matter what happens, football doesn't always come first. It shows that people's health is always priority over a football game. And it's like really good that both Burton and Barnsley did decide to postpone the game just because of it was obviously serious. So it just shows that both teams can work together and put on a display of such strength to show that, yeah, they need the help. So we're going to let them have it. We're going to get rid of all the fans. We're going to, like, just make sure that their health is priority. So I do hope that whoever it was that was injured today is okay, and I hope that, and I wish them a speedy recovery, because it's sometimes you just can't help it. All the time you can't help if you collapse, but there's no better place for, if you do collapse, there's no better place and to do it than a football stadium where there's tons of medical team. There's, especially today as well, it was a retro day at the club, but they also had St John's Hospice workers in teaching people how to do CPR just on little dummies. And it's just, of all days, it was better to have all this staff here to help, so they could all come from the stations and come and help. But credit goes out to all ambulance workers and all like staff that help out. I don't know, I forgot the words for it, I'm just lost for words, but all emergency responder teams, like the pilots that flew the helicopter out and the ambulance drivers and everybody at Barnsley Football Club that has helped. So it's just really, really good to see. And I do hope that whoever it was has a really quick recovery, because it's not good to see. But yeah, thank you for watching. If this has upset you, please just, if you didn't like it, you're obviously not watching, but I just hope you enjoyed this, and I hope it makes you more aware of what can happen at football games if we don't take it seriously. And obviously, people's health is superior over anything football related. So yeah, thank you guys for watching, and subscribe if you're new to the channel, turn on notifications, and just my thoughts and prayers go out to that family. I hope everything's okay, and I hope you can sort it all out from the bottom of my heart. So thank you for watching.